The Philippines sending help to Indonesia as it plans to export excess oxygen tanks there soon. Philippine Ambassador to Indonesia Lee Hyong Wee says supplies of medical-grade oxygen will be sourced from two local manufacturers. The Trade Department is already finalizing the logistics of the export.
Yung mga oxygen, dahil talagang kulang at saka wala pa. Oh, there were two companies here that were pinpointed not to have excess capacity. Yun ang papabenta sa Indonesia to help them out.
The Delta variant continues to ravage Indonesia, with the country recording its biggest daily increase in coronavirus infections on Wednesday at 54,517. That's up more than tenfold since the start of June. 991 additional deaths were also registered. According to Indonesia's health minister, the Delta variant, first identified in India, has been found in 11 areas outside the densely populated Java Island. Cases and bed occupancy in far-flung regions have risen at concerning rates, prompting government to deploy more than 2,000 newly graduated doctors and 20,000 nurses. Volunteer ambulance drivers also taking a vital role in supporting the struggling healthcare service. One volunteer says the team can get up to 80 calls per day from patients desperate to get to a hospital, but it only has resources to help 30. Indonesia is the latest country to be added on the Philippines' travel ban list. That's as officials try to ward off the more infectious Delta COVID-19 variant, which is currently driving a surge in coronavirus infections in the region. Inbound travelers from Indonesia will be barred from entering the Philippines beginning July 16th. Until July 31st. But those already in transit will be let in, provided they undergo a 14-day quarantine. A current Philippine travel ban on seven other countries, including India and the UAE, was also extended until the end of the month. Myanmar suffers its most severe wave of COVID-19 infections so far. The military-ruled nation reported 7,089 new cases and 145 deaths on Wednesday. Both new records. Efforts to contain the virus has been hampered by daily protests against the junta, with health workers joining the movement as well. A spokesman for the military said they are doing all they could to ramp up health services, including opening up military hospitals to the public. Over in Singapore, nearly 3,000 passengers and crew have finally left a cruise ship after a COVID-19 case left them stuck for hours in their rooms through most of Wednesday. The patient, a 40-year-old passenger, tested positive on board, forcing the ship to dock earlier than planned. The result was confirmed after the person was taken to the hospital. Singapore's tourism board says the passenger was identified as a close contact of a confirmed case on land. Local media reported that the case on the ship was part of a growing cluster of COVID-19 infections associated with karaoke lounges. Singapore on Wednesday recorded 56 locally transmitted cases, the highest number of domestic daily infections in 10 months.